At the tone, leave your name and message. I'll get back to you.
Hello, you the guy who lost the wallet in the Park Theater? Well, I'm kind of like into leather, so I'll be returning the money, but I'm going to keep the wallet.
Well, I was walking past the looping stage, and this fella, he grabbed me and said that they needed somebody to read this narration because the guy that they hired didn't show up. He said it was for the Rockford Files joke reel. Well, that's kind of news to me. I didn't know y'all had jokes on the Rockford Files. See, I've been watching the show for almost 5 years, and the thing that impresses me the most is that y'all will take a situation where some folks will get crazy, I mean zany even, and you'll do it with such style and sophistication. And Jim, now Jim, he's a very sophisticated guy.
Thanks for the burrito.
All right, hold it down. We're this serious. We're rolling.
Rolling. From the top?
Thank you. Good tone in the whole game. We rolling?
Yeah. And
now, of course, you don't have to tell me that one of the things that makes it possible to make one of these TV serial things is your actors have to show up every morning knowing their words, ready to work, secure in the knowledge that we're going to get it in one take.
All right, Lori.
This is really nice of you. I mean, asking me out.
Oh, it's okay, Gail. I wanted to.
You don't have to say that, Mr. Rockford. I know Johnny made you do it. He says I don't ever date, but I do. I mean, not
I'm
a lot.
Sorry, let's keep rolling, honey. You're leaning in just a touch too much, Jim. You know what I'm saying?
All right,
just enjoying.
He says that I don't ever date, but I do.
No, I'm going to go to the top, honey. Just looking around. Right from the very top. And keep your pace up, honey. Action.
This is really nice of you. I mean, asking me out.
It's okay, Gail. I wanted to.
Hey, you don't have to say that, Mr. Rockford. I know Jimmy put you up to it.
Hey, it's okay, Gail. I wanted to.
Hey, you don't have to say that, Mr. Rockford. I know Johnny made you do it. He says I don't ever date, but I do. I mean, not a lot, because of all the extra classification at the university. We're completely redoing the entire physics research category.
Yeah, let's just start from the top.
Start
right
from the very top. Just
what about the principal? Everything you've mentioned, including Seal's mother's gallstone.
Kidney.
She could have had them both. You could afford them. But everything you have mentioned could have been paid out of the principal. No, it could have been paid out of the interest. Okay, including Seal. Okay, including where? Pick me up.
Not me, Seal. Not me, Seal's mother. Seal's mother. Stones.
It's against the law to show civilians someone's rap sheet.
Well, then don't show it to me, Joe. Just tell me, Joe,
Dennis.
You're Dennis.
Got
my stomach was growling and I'm laughing. Everybody heard.
I think we've said about all we have to say to each other.
Not yet. Sit down. I got a long speech.
Yeah.
Just everything hold still now.
Action.
Just hold yourself together and we'll do it.
This is really nice of you, I mean, asking me out.
It's okay, Gail, I wanted to.
Hey, you don't have to say that, Mr. Rockford. I know Johnny made you do it. He says I don't ever date, but I do. I mean, not a lot, because of all the extra
Donofrio is the parolee Mrs. Town was playing slappy steps up and proof for. You like that?
Yes.
Do it, go again.
You mean we're gonna have to question him?
How would it look if we didn't?
I always do this.
Go back to that scene, man. You know, statistically.
You know, Frank, speaking as professionals, and as I said, and as you know, statistically, cheap.
You want to cut it?
Yeah, please.
Action! Okay, go.
Take the batteries out of the flashlights and the radios.
Swell, just swell.
Well, that Mr. Collins called anyway a couple of days ago and said that he had bad news for you.
Boy, bad news for you, too.
Do you mind?
Christmas. Dad, if you're going to fix something, why didn't you fix that?
Oh, now, I think that you're taking your jury duty too darn serious. That was lousy.
Cut!
This is really nice of you. I mean, asking me out. You and Johnny must really be great friends.
Yeah, well, we share a similar, what is it?
Something for lack of nonconformity. Or something.
For the establishment.
Yeah.
We share a certain, something for the establishment. Yeah, we share a certain thing for the establishment. What made you say that?
I'll tell you one thing. Ralph Walsh didn't kill Olivia. Ralph Walsh.
He wasn't even in it. It's another
picture
of a different name. Okay.
Out there, I want you to go back and say, in my father's day, you and I would be in the bar.
In my pardon me?
In my father's day, you and I would be in the bois with pistols.
Oh, yeah.
And go.
In my father's day, we would be in the bois with pistols.
Now, change the we to you and I. Okay? And go.
In my father's day, we would be in the bois.
Cut.
Yeah, what do you want?
Sir. Parker. Ready? Background. Action.
In my father's day, you and I, we would be in the bois with pistols.
You knew who
once
he was.
More. Once more, you and I would be in the bois with pistols. And action.
In my father's day, you and I.
Start it again. And once again.
In my father's day, you and I, we would be in the bois with pistols.
Or, if he managed to get to you, no, if he managed to kill you, if he just managed.
Say it, please.
Say it.
That's just what I said. That's my own personal stuff in there.
Oh, shit. Okay,
I
have nothing to feel guilty about.
That's what.
I may not display my emotions, Mr. Whatever your name is.
Rockford.
I forgot!
Rockford!
You're very nice, Jim, and I appreciate you taking me out. I know, Johnny.
Hey, would you quit putting yourself down? God, I'm going crazy. What is it? Quit putting yourself? Oh, well. Do it again.
You're very nice, Jim, and I appreciate you taking me out.
Hey, will you quit putting yourself down, Gailey? You're very attractive. You're a well-educated woman. We're going to have a good time this weekend.
Yeah, I don't know, David. I don't think they're ever going to get it.
Well, you know, I guess every now and then that sort of thing is going to happen. Anyway, when it does, I'm going to tell you something. You're going to hear from all those folks in the front office, the ones, who write these scripts and watch over the pot while it's cooking.
Who changed my curtain line? Boy, I really loved that line.
When these lines were written, a lot of thought went into them, so lay off down there.
The next line that gets changed is going to end up getting printed in the middle of somebody's forehead. And where's the coverage? Let's step on the goddamn Rembrandt once in a while, okay?
All right, now, God damn.
Now, I never could figure out why writers get so upset about that, really. I think the real crime is cutting the actor's best moments out of the picture. Now, here's one that I just, I wanted to see get in somewhere. That fellow there, that he can really set a horse. Of course, noise is a problem on location.
Oh, yeah. Tracing the John C. Fremont High School class of 62, the lives and love, the tragedy and the heartbreak of 200 fry cooks and hotel elevator operators. Let me get this garbage truck to the spot. No, maybe it wasn't a mistake.
Oh, come on, Jim.
I was careful. When I drove you over to Maggie's, I had both eyes on the rearview mirror at all. The only guy who would pay a fortune to keep him alive is high. The only guy I messed it up. The only guy who pay a fortune. Oh, shit, I ain't gonna fight it.
Okay,
We had our own solution to that on McLeod.
Boy, you talk about the Nazis around you and it rubs off.
This is really nice of you. I mean, asking me out.
It's okay, Gail. I wanted to.
Hey, you don't have to say that, Mr. Rockford. I know Jimmy put you up to it.
It's
he
Johnny.
Says that...
Hey, it's okay, Gail.
Mm-hmm. It's better.
Yeah,
it's getting better. Old Gardner, he told me, he said, Dennis, see, that's my name. He said, how is it that your crews are always all banged up and mine are so healthy? Well, I told him, Jimmy. I said, Jimmy, making movies is dangerous, and sometimes you're going to get an injury. Well, he said, not on my company, you don't.
Sorry, Tony.
I can't see. Coop, can you see?
Can't see a thing.
I'm gonna have to stop. I'm just gonna have to stop.
God damn it. I'm sorry, Chuck.
Hey.
I assumed you knew we were gonna stop.
You know, one thing I like about on the Rockford Files is that they do simple, understandable stories.
All right. Just try this one on for size, huh?
Dennis Carr was murdered by Eric Saunders because he was trying to shake him down. Nancy Hellman was dusted off for the same reason. Nancy walked in on her boyfriend Prentice to help him count the money, only she found him dead. She didn't want a murder investigation, so she tried to make it look like Carr committed suicide. That means she knew why Saunders was being blackmailed. I think you know, too.
You're out of your mind. I don't know nothing.
Hey, we gotta try to fit this thing together, huh?
That's too much data. I can't even keep it straight.
Hey, guy, well, then why did they steal Rocky's jeans? And how do you figure naval intelligence in this?
It's a crime of sexual passion.
Who is this Timson Farrell, anyway? I thought he had something to do with rare coins.
He does.
And he killed people for a living?
And used his coin shop as a cover. His last contract was a big one. The four men that were scheduled to appear before the Senate subcommittee. The Cowley family didn't want them talking, so he hired Farrell to see that they didn't.
Herman Keitel, Louis Garone, and Arnold Freeling. Who was the fourth man?
Want to hear about Alva Corpa? Tell her to talk to the ghost of Olivia Duran, whom he murdered. She'll get in here for whom.
Corper murdered who?
Might as well have. His poor wife. Despondent and desperate. No wonder they found her in a tub full of her own blood. Tell her to talk to Julio Sanchez.
Whose brother Raul was gunned down in the street.
Boy, it's a mess, isn't it? Tell you, Dennis, I think my head's gonna bust open.
Oh, I tell you, I do like romance in a show. You betcha.
Jimmy. Hey, come on, that ain't funny. Officer? Officer, you get a chance? You think you could, I guess, under the circumstances, out of the question.
Of course, all of this leads up to a very friendly set.
Phenomenal. I almost got through that.
Get off of my sister!
Now, I got a line in there, folks.
Don't you laugh at me. Don't you ever shout at me, Noreen.
Action.
And let's remember that this film that we're shooting costs 50 cents a foot.
On a false arrest charge, some turkey yells police brutality. You see, this pop. Go ahead. Go.
Okay, you want to tell me? Sorry.
I don't know what you're talking about. Now, you got about 5 seconds to get out that door. You're going butt over tea kettle out that window, and we're 26 floors up, Mr. Wincoast. Mr. Coombs? Do it again. Do it again. Just go. Go, go, go.
And another thing I like is with your running characters, this, those relationships, they just keep getting stronger. I like Rocky, the way that he loves old Jim and Becker and Angel.
What's the matter? Can't get your tongue? I'm not worried, he says. Daddy, he folded like a cheap paper bag. I never saw anything like
that. Put a cork in it, Angel.
Big Goody Two-Shoes gonna be the model citizen. What happened to Mr. Do-Right?
Listen, Angel, I am happy with you. I'm going crazy, do you understand? You're driving me crazy.
Jimmy.
I can't take it anymore. Year after year after year, I'm going out of my mind. You stupid, ridiculous lies and games year after year.
And my windpipe. Oh.
Look at me, look at me.
Hey, Jimmy. Just don't say anything. Just don't say anything. Jimmy.
What?
I'm sorry. You wanna stick a fruit gum?
That's about it. That's all there is. Of course, there is this one more thing. You know, some folks think that a TV star is just doing it for the money. But I know that Jim Garner, I know him pretty darn well. And this Garner fella, he doesn't do the Rockford Files for money. He does it because it's just so much darn fun. The money? Well, that comes from the real paying customers, the folks that say they got a one-step. Of course, you know, I could have had that account myself. They wanted me to do it, but that there is a... You see, the problem is that that's a two-step camera, and I just wasn't going to lie about it.
Oh, fellas, I'm sorry I'm late about the narration. The traffic, I'm telling you, is getting murdered. If they pick up the show, next year I'm going to get a place in town at Howard Johnson's. I mean it. I can't take this anymore. I'm free from Malibu. Okay, where's the copy?
You mean the Rockford copy?
Yeah, I'm ready to do the narrating.
Well, somebody's already done it.
What do you mean? No, I'm going to do it. Who?
Mr. Dennis Weaver.
Dennis Weaver? You got that? I'm supposed to do it. You got that hillbilly bastard? Me? I came all the way from Malibu. Jim, shit!
Action. I mean, cut.